far as pop, rock and roll kind of bands, it's not really too much of a scene right now. It's actually kind of a tough place to come out of. I don't think the rest of the country looks upon Washington like they do Boston or San Francisco.
Right,
or, you know,
as a hotbed of music.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a drawback.
You mentioned a whole different range of styles of pop or the hard rock or even go-go, the go-go scene. Now you're really none of those. You do a Lou Reed song.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about some of the people who you loved growing up?
Sure. It's we get a lot of sort of the 60s. People say, well, you're really a 60s influenced person. And I am actually from a songwriting point of view. I mean, I started with the Beatles, and I was a record buying fanatic, and I used to go see shows. And I was really lucky. My parents used to drive me
to... Still buying records?
Oh, yeah. My parents used to drop us off at concerts like they dropped other kids off at the movies. So I saw some amazing shows, excuse me, when I was 9, 10, stuff like that. But,
Well, we got the video coming up.
Yeah.
Your first video, which was shot in what looks to be a beautiful theater, maybe?
Yeah, it's this old sort of movie palace going to seed in downtown L.A. Mm-hmm. It's called Los Angeles Theater, and we shot it in the lobby, actually. And I think Nightmare on Elm Street Part 2 was playing while we were there. So. But I guess in its heyday, it was a great sort of palace. But it's, I heard they might tear it down, but I don't know.
Let's have a look at it, and we'll come back and talk more with Tommy Keane. This is called Places That Are Gone.
Have you heard the words you wanted to hear? Is my body heat the right intensity?
Here's John Taylor's I Do What I Do, and Tommy Keene is our guest. New artist, new album just out called Songs from the Film. We can show America right now. See the wonder of television, what the album cover looks like. And we just saw the video. It's a real pretty piece of work, and it looks in a lot of ways to be kind of elaborate with all those stills busting up. And how involved did you get in that, and who directed it, and
well,
what was
actually,
it like?
I got Warner Brothers set me up with this young, sort of up-and-coming, hot filmmaker from L.A. named Rocky Shank, and this is, I think, his second sort of big production video. And he had a film, actually, well, this is where the film comes in, that was called Egyptian Princess, which he shot in L.A., actually at the same theater.
Now, is that, there's, in the video, there is one, is it in black and white, this film?
Yeah.
And there's one brief segment, it looks like, where it's this sort of princess is walking up the steps.
Right.
Is that?
Well, yeah, actually, there's a bunch of little excerpts from the film that are in the video. So he also did that, and then, you know, we had the pictures ripping up, which are actual stills from this film, Egyptian Princess. So it all kind of worked out well, tied in. So we have a film, but the film's not coming out, so that's, you know, it's still sort of up in the air. But
I'm very confused.
That's the point.
Get the soundtrack.
Right.
Don't go see the film. I understand perfectly. You're on. You're opening now for Lloyd Cole and the Commotions.
Right. Yeah.
And has that taken you to different sorts of venues than you've been used to playing?
It will, because we're heading out to the Midwest and the West Coast. And actually, we've never played the West Coast, so this should be good. We just started last night in Boston. So.
You looking forward to it?
Yeah, it's great. It's finally, you know, we're out on the road and promoting a major label record, and all the machinery goes to work. So we're having a great time.
I'm going to drop back to something that we talked about in another segment, because you really didn't answer one of the things that I mentioned about this Lou Reed song.
Oh, that's right. Who influences and stuff.
Yeah, and to me, you have a very English feel, certainly in the harmonics and the change, chord changes and stuff. And Lou Reed is like, not like that at all.
Well, I don't know. I think...
Why did you do that song?
Well, the real reason why we did it is because... it was just a cover song that we were sort of throwing around, and someone said, you should really put that on the record. And I was kind of, no, no, because I really don't like to record cover songs that much. But anyway, it just, it filled a sort of a void on the record. I think it added it just made, gave the record a certain versatility that it didn't have otherwise. But no, I mean, Lou Reed was very much connected with the whole British scene, actually. David Bowie produced Transformer, which was, I guess, Lou's first big record after Velvet Underground. But no, I thought Kill Your Sons was a great sort of Looked over Lou Reed's song. You know, maybe it could be his next Sweet Jane or something. You know, I don't know. But
Tommy Keane, really good to meet you. Good luck.
Thank you.
And American Watch can watch for this guy on the road with Lloyd Cole and the Commotions. Still to come, John Cougar Mellencamp, that's Five Away with R.O.C.K. in the USA. Patton Moore tonight.